Let's practice some yoga. Let's lie down. Bring the soles of the feet together if it feels okay. If it doesn't, do whatever else feels good. And then release the back of the head, release the shoulders, the arms, the hands. Everything just kind of starts to soften down. Just taking a few breaths here. Without feeling the need to change the breath, just observe the breath. Watch it. Notice how it feels coming in, coming out. And then the simple act of observing the breath typically starts to deepen the breath. So you don't actually have to try. Which is kind of nice because we're always trying, right? We're always trying. Today, I invite you to just receive your practice, receive your breath. Whatever happens to come, comes. Doesn't mean that you're not putting effort out. Inhale, reach your arms overhead. On the next exhale, draw the knees in. If you need to use your hands to help them do that, take your knees over to the right. Take your left arm high, up and over to the left. Come back through center. And then same to the other side. Knees go left, right arm high. Up and over to the right. Come back to center, cross your right ankle on your left thigh. Don't go anywhere, just open the knee. Press the ankle against the thigh. Bring your hands to your hips, balance your hips, broaden across the collarbones. So it's less about cranking your legs in toward you. It's more about keeping the stability in the pelvis, keeping the spine in neutral, and then finding this pressure, ankle to thigh and knee outward. So if you want, lift the left leg up and then you support, maybe here are the hands. You might not need the hands. Maybe you just work the legs here without holding on. Down, switch your feet. Same setup, foot stays down, leg stays down, hands to your pelvis. Balance things out. Notice if the sides of your body get shorter on one side when you pull the leg up. See if you can balance that. And then lift the legs up if you want. You don't have to. You can hold on if you want. If you don't need that support, maybe just working here. So you're gently drawing your right knee in toward your chest and you're pushing your left ankle, your shin, your left knee forward, and you're lengthening this inner left thigh. Last inhale, release the foot, release the foot. Bring your arms at your sides, inhale. Exhale, curl the shoulders up. Inhale a little higher. Exhale, release it down. Inhale. Exhale, curl it up. Stay and inhale. Exhale, curl a little higher. Release it down, inhale. Exhale, curl up. Stay for the inhale. Exhale, higher. Inhale, release it down. One more like that. Exhale, curl. Stay inhale. Exhale, curl higher. This time, pick up your legs and then curl your torso down. Arms at your sides, broaden the chest, root the shoulders down. Keep the spine exactly how it is, nice and neutral. Inhale, exhale, feet toward the floor. Inhale, bring it up. Exhale, feet toward the floor. Doesn't mean you have to touch, it doesn't have to be big, it could be really small. So your guide here is the position of your spine. If your spine starts moving all over the place, you need to make it small. One more, and then pause. Inhale, exhale, curl the shoulders up. Inhale, release it down. Exhale, feet toward the ground. Inhale, back up. Exhale, curl. Release it down. Bring the feet down. Bring it back up. Curl it up. Release it down. Feet down. Feet up. Two more. One more. Knees in, give yourself a squeeze. Separate the knees wide if it feels okay. Come back through center, up to boat pose, rising up here. Yeah, good. Beautiful. Good, good, good. Stay in your breath. Cross your shins. And then step back to plank. Strong in plank. Hands rooting down. Press into the base of the index finger. The base of the thumb. Draw your thumbs toward each other. Spiral your pinky fingers toward the edges of the mat. Thighs to the sky. Knees to the sky. Kneecaps up on the thighs. Your heart is stretching forward. Your heels are stretching back. You're moving your energy in opposite directions. Tip forward into your toes. Come halfway down, chaturanga. Come back up to plank and downward facing dog. Inhale forward to plank, chaturanga. Inhale up. Downward facing dog. One more time. Inhale, forward to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Back up, inhale. Downward facing dog. Right leg back, inhale. Open your hip, lift the leg high, 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 and then bend the knee. Circle your ankle. Reverse it. Keep that left arm strong. Bring your right knee to your right tricep. And then place your right foot outside your right hand. Back knee down. And then opening up here. Nice, easy, gentle twist over. Yeah. One more inhale. Come around, exhale, release that right hand down. Tuck the back toes. You can bring your right foot a little more to the left. Turn the back heel down to the center of the mat. Warrior two, rising up. Lift this right hip up to rise up. Extend through the arms. Inhale, straighten the front leg. reach the arms up. And then re-bend the front leg, reverse warrior. Sink even deeper than you were in warrior two. One more inhale. Come around with your exhale. Hands come down to the ground. Come up onto the back toes. Pop your back foot in a little closer to your front foot. Straighten both of your legs. Extend your spine forward. So lengthen the spine forward rather than just dropping the head down. Really get some extension here. Good. Come even higher onto the left toes. Plant your left hand as far forward as you need to get that length out. Right hand comes behind your head. You're gonna inhale, open up, and then exhale, release it down. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Push into that bottom hand to give yourself that rotation, open, inhale. Exhale, release. Last one, inhale. Exhale, release the hand. Step back to plank. Chaturanga with your exhale. Rise up dog. Downward facing dog with your exhale. Take a pause here. Give yourself a moment. Reconnect breath in case it kind of eluded you. And then left leg back and down. Open the hip. Keep the leg straight. Lift it higher, and then bend the knee. Circle the ankle. Keep pushing into this right arm, nice and strong. Reverse the circle of the ankle. And then left knee, left tricep. Place your left foot outside of your left hand. And then back knee down. And then just opening up, pushing into this right hand to solidify the shoulder blade in the back and opening here. Nice and soft in this top arm. One more inhale. Release this hand around. Tuck the back toes, lift the knee, walk the left foot a little closer to the center line, then turn the back heel down. Rise up to warrior two. Yes. Really nice. Yes. Beautiful. Good fit. Stay and breathe there.
Really nice. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Excellent.
Inhale, straighten the front leg, rise. Good, re-bend the front leg even deeper and then reverse for your back. Inhale, draw around. Good, come up onto the back toes. You can take that left a little wider and then bring the hands down. Slide the back foot a little closer to the front foot. You're up on the back toes. And rather than folding over the front leg, see if you can draw the spine long. Pull the feet toward each other. Yes. Good. Come really high into the back toes. So check if you start to kind of get lazy in that back foot. Move the right hand forward a little bit more if you need to. Hand comes behind the head. Inhale. Open up. Push into this bottom hand. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale, release it down. Step back to plank. Inhale, chaturanga. Exhale. rise to open, inhale. Dog pose, exhale. Onto your toes with your inhale. Bend your knees, stretch your heart forward, stretch your hips back, and then bring your feet to your hands. Use that extension back. Halfway, inhale. Fold down, exhale. Rise to stand, inhale. Draw your hands into your heart, exhale. Big inhale. Full exhale out. Do that again. Big inhale. Full exhale out. Last time, just standing in Tadasana, inhale. And exhale. Release your hands. Inhale, rise up, reach up. Maybe the gaze comes up. Exhale, forward fold all the way down.
Halfway up, inhale.
Plant your hands, chaturanga, exhale. Rise, open, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Smooth out your breath. Steady inhale, steady exhales. Yes, yes, yes. Keep the breath constant. Inhale, high to your toes. Bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold down, exhale. Rise to stand, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bow forward. Kneecaps lift, hinge at the hips.
Inhale, halfway.
Hands plant, elbows hug in, chaturanga. Rise, up dog. Down dog, exhale. Inhale
to your toes. Bend your knees. Feel your fingertips in the ground. Feet to your hands.
Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale.
Rise to stand, inhale.
Draw your hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bow forward.
Halfway, inhale.
Chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale.
Inhale to your toes. Bend your knees. Look forward, feet to your hands.
Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale.
Rise, inhale.
Hands into your heart, exhale. Chair pose, bend your knees, drop your hips. Lift the heart. Really good, yes, really good. Shift the shins back. Keep the toes down, but let the heels catch. Hands into your heart. Left arm outside your right thigh. And then press into this left arm to wrap open. You're going to bring your right hand behind your head. Then lift the elbow and open the shoulder. Yes. Really nice. Sweep the right arm back behind you. Come through center. Right leg is your standing leg, left knee comes up. Push through half moon.
Scoop the left hand to the back of the mat. Bend your standing leg. Bring this left knee in line with the right knee. Single leg chair. And then press up to stand. Right hand, left knee, left arm goes back. If you're comfortable taking the foot, go for it. But you've got time, you've got time. So if you're still feeling like you're warming up those hamstrings and the twisting muscles, there's no rush. And then come back to chair, top of your mat. Hands into your heart. Right arm outside your left leg, we twist to the left. Take this left hand behind your head. Lift the elbow, use your right arm against that left leg to open up. Notice if your right knee starts to drop forward, keep pulling that right leg in line with your left. That's kind of like a little check to see if you're actually twisting from your spine or if you've shifted your pelvis to go into the twist. Yes. Yes, yes. And then sweep that left arm back behind you. Come around. Your left leg is your standing leg, your right leg rises up. And then we push open half moon. Take your time. Steady your gaze, steady your breath. So nice. Sweep this right arm to the back leg. Come around. Sit to bend both of your knees. Keep this right leg off the floor. Come into single leg chair pose. And then rise up to stand and we twist to the right. Knee or foot. Well done. Very, very nice. Yes, very good. Really beautiful. Last inhale. Gently release. Exhale. Chair pose. Inhale. Forward fold. Exhale.
Halfway. Inhale.
Chaturanga Vinyasa to downward facing dog. So you can skip these, modify however you need in your transitions.
Right leg back. Inhale.
Right knee, left tricep. Five breaths here. Work the chest forward. Extend the right leg out. Fall in triangle. Open it up. Bring your left hand back down, come back onto those left toes. Pull the knee back into the chest, stretch up and back. Open the hips, look over if you would like. And then with care, stepping your right foot top of the mat. Turn the back heel down, keep your left hand down. Inhale, right hand to the sky, revolve triangle, but let it be nice and easy so you don't have to go crazy here. Good. Pull the right hip back gently. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Beautiful. Sweep this right arm down to the back of the mat and around. Come onto the back toes, warrior three, just lifting off. Arms overhead if you want. Hands at your heart, it can be alongside the body, whatever feels good to you here. You're going to bend your standing leg, start to turn the left hip open. We're coming into reverse warrior, so step way back with that left foot. Take it up and back, we've been here.
And then bring it around and down to the ground.
Step back to plank, chaturanga, exhale.
Rise up dog, downward facing dog. Left leg back in hand. Cross to the right, you've got about 5 breaths. And extend this left leg out. Fallen triangle, really good. Bring this right hand back down. Come onto the right toes, pull the knee back into the chest. Open up, flipping your dog if you want. And then slowly coming around, left foot top of the mat. So your stance doesn't have to be very long. It's a little shorter than if you were in Warrior Two or Crescent Pose. Back heel roots down, right hand stays down on the floor. Start to turn the chest open to the left, and then left arm up. Use your bottom hand to lift up more. So push down to lift. One more inhale. Exhale, sweep the arm around. Come onto the back toes, Warrior Three, with care, lifting off. Start to bend the standing leg. Open up the right hip. We reverse the warrior up and back. Really, really nice. One more inhale, and then bring your hands around. Step back to plank, inhale, chaturanga, exhale. Rise, inhale. Dog pose, exhale. Pause here and breathe, pause here and breathe. Good. We're gonna take that one time a little faster, then we'll add on and get all sorts of creative and whatnot. Trust that it's in your body. It is, it's there. Trust, you don't have to try. Receive the practice. Doesn't mean that there's not effort, but you don't have to try. Receive the poses, receive the breath. Right leg back in hand. Cross to the left. Extend the leg, fallen triangle, opening up. Bring it around. Open up. Flip over to wild thing if you like. And then step the right foot top of the mat. Good. Back heel roots down. Straighten both legs. Revolve triangle, nice and easy. Sweep the arm back. Reaching forward, up onto the back toes. Warriors Three. And then reverse the warrior. So bend the leg, come back. And then bring it around, hands to the ground. Step back to plank. Chaturanga. Rise. Down dog, exhale. Left leg back. Cross to the right. Extend the leg. Fallen triangle. Bring it back around. Open the hip. Flip if you'd like. Step the left foot top of the mat. Turn the right heel in and down. Straighten both legs as best you can. Revolve triangle. Release the arm back and around. Up onto the back toes for Warrior Three. Reverse warrior, bend that front leg, step it back. Up and back, beautiful. Bring it around. And then chaturanga. Rounds. And down dog. Pause in your breath, really, really nice. Huh.
Hi to your toes, inhale.
Bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair pose, inhale. Hands into heart. Left arm outside the right thigh, twist to the right. Yeah, beautiful. Come back through center. Right leg is your standing leg, left knee rises up. Good, half moon, opening up. Maybe Shavasana. If you have the foot, release it. Bend the standing leg, bring this left knee around. You're in single leg chair. And then press up. Turning to the left, taking the foot or the knee and twisting to your left. Come back through center. Leg stays up, pause. Chair pose, bring it back down. Hands into your heart, right arm outside the left thigh. We twist it open. Few breaths here. Come back through center, your left leg is your standing leg, your right knee rises up. You push through to half moon. And then option to bend the top leg and find your foot. Couple breaths. And then release the foot. You're just gonna float this right knee around for single leg chair. And then push up. Take your left hand to your right knee or to your foot. And we twist. Gorgeous. Yes. Receive your breath. Come back through center. Leg up. Chair pose. Inhale. Forward fold. Exhale.
Halfway. Inhale.
Chaturanga. Exhale. Rise, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Everything you need is in your system. It's in your brain. Trust and receive and breathe. Right leg back, inhale. Cross to the left. Fallen triangle. Maybe float this right leg. And then bring it back around. Flip up and over. Wild thing if you care to. And then bring that right foot top of the mat. Revolve triangle, root the back heel, opening up. Take the arm to the back of the neck. Warrior three. Reverse warrior. Stay with me. Bring your hands around, hi boo. Standing splits on this right leg. So lift this left leg up, fantastic. Stay here, breathe. Come to chair pose, top of the mat. Hands into your heart, and then twist open to the right, left arm to left, right thigh. If you wanna open it, go for it. We've done a few twists now. Your body might feel ready. Really nice. You're gonna sweep this right arm back behind you. Right leg is your standing leg, lift the left knee up. Push through to half moon, any variation that you like. And then single leg chair. So you're staying on this right leg. And then lift the left knee up, take the foot or the knee with the right hand, and then twist to your left. Good, come back through center. Keep that leg lifted. Keep that leg lifted. And then sweep the left leg through. Bring your hands down to the ground. Either step back to plank straight from here. If you want, you can take a lift or two and see if you find even just a second of balance. And then chaturanga. Rise and down dog. Exhale. Left leg back, inhale. Cross to the right. Fall in triangle, maybe float this left leg. And then bring it back around.
Flip around. Wild thing if you want.
Left foot top of the mat. Right heel roots in and down. Easy twisting triangle. If there's such a thing, easy twisting triangle. Good. Sweep the hand to the back of the mat. Warrior three, lifting off. Reverse warrior. Take it back. Beautiful. And then standing splits top of your mat.
Chair pose, inhale.
Exhale, twist to your left, right arm out. Maybe open the arms up. Take the left arm back. Come around, your left leg is your standing leg, your right knee rises up. Half moon, any variation. You're coming back into single leg chair. And then rise up. Left hand to right knee or to your foot. Yes. Twist it open. Beautiful. Beautiful. Come back through center. Keep that leg lifted. Two breaths. And then sweep the leg through. Hands to the ground. Either step to plank from there. Or take a lift or two here. Don't try. Just receive. Chaturanga. Exhale. Yes. Right. Inhale. And downward facing dog. Exhale. Reset your breath. Inhale, right leg back. Knee to chest, exhale, shift forward. Do that again. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Draw your foot forward. Bring your hands into your heart. Stay tipped forward. Inhale. Exhale. Twist to the right. Hook this left arm outside the thigh. If that feels like it's too deep, bring your hand to the ground inside of the right foot. Okay. If you want, top arm comes up. If you want, bottom hand comes down. You can wrap this if you want. Find what you need today. Back leg really strong. Your right hip tends to want to kind of pop off to the side and shift forward. Hug it in and back. Pull the heart forward. Pull the belly forward. Press that left heel back. Yes. Really beautiful. For as much as this right thigh and hip are sinking, the left thigh is lifting. One more inhale. Release the hands down. Walk your hands around to your left. Pivot your feet for Prasarita, Padottanasana, right here.
If you're a headstander and you're comfortable, you can bring the crown of the head down. Feel that you have equal weight between your head and your hands. You shouldn't feel like everything is in your head. That's not gonna feel good, right? So work the thumbs toward each other, pinky fingers out, and then maybe straddle those legs up. Keep the elbows working toward each other. And then straddle down. And then everyone halfway up.
Walk your hands to the top of your mat. Good. But if it feels good, your back knee can come down. If it doesn't, keep it up. If you want, you can reach back, find your foot with your hand, and then gently open up the chest, gently push the hand and the foot into each other. Really nice. One more breath in. If you have the foot, release it gently. You're gonna walk this right foot across. Not too far. Keep the knee pretty wide. We're coming into single leg pigeon. Your shin never has to be parallel to the top of your mat. So get that out of your head immediately. It might, but it doesn't have to. So you might even start with the foot closer in toward the left hip. And then as you're here, you can decide to move it. Back foot active, front ankle, front foot, front shin active, so you feel really strong here. And then if it feels okay on your body, we're gonna walk our hands over to the right. It really helps to keep this back leg active. If you want, you can bring your elbow to your thigh if you feel centered, and then we take a twist. Last full breath here, nice and strong. Release the hands around. Tuck the back toes, step back to plank. Your choice whether or not you go through Chaturanga Vinyasa, you can simply go back into downward facing dog if you would rather. Left leg back in hand. Exhale, knee to chest, shift forward. Inhale back. Same thing, exhale down the center. Inhale back. Exhale, bring the foot forward. Stay low. Make sure your foundation is wide enough that you feel stable here. So maybe the right leg needs to go further to the right. Bring your hands into your heart. Inhale, exhale, twist. Right arm hooks that left leg if it's okay. If it's not okay, keep your head on the floor here and you can open here. And then here, all the same stuff applies. Maybe open the arms up, maybe wrap it. Notice if that left hip is swinging out to the left side and moving forward, gently hug it in and draw it back. And then powerful back leg. And then this front thigh is sinking, but the back leg is rising. So you've got this opposite energy that allows you more stability, allows you to go deeper into the pose. Yes. Really good. And then release out of that twist. Bring the hands around all the way. And then wide leg, forward fold. If you want to change up the arm position here, you can. If you wanted a second shot at headstand, you're welcome to go there now. Take your time with it. Take your time with it. If you want to lace the hands behind the head instead, behind the hips rather, instead, you are welcome to.
If you took a headstand, come back down.
And then everyone, draw the heart forward. Walk your hands around to the top of the mat. Option to put the back knee down. Option to bend the back leg and find your foot. Using this right shoulder to give you more stability. If the right shoulder is just kind of dumping and you're resting in it and you're not active, you're losing out on a huge element of the twist. So this is foundational. This gives you shoulder blade into back, and that helps to bring the heart around. And then release the back foot if you have it. Walk the left foot over to the right. And then come into single leg, pigeon here. Active front ankle, front foot, shin, knee. Active back foot, back shin. And then maybe walk your hands over to the left. Maybe take the right arm to the left thigh. And then twist. You really have to use your center. Back around your center, plant your hands, step it back, vinyasa if you'd like, otherwise just straight to down dog. And just pause. Receive your breath. Hide your toes, inhale. Bend your knees, exhale. Look forward, feet to your hands. Come halfway, inhale. Stay here and breathe. Walk the hands forward a little bit more. And then send your left leg back in space. Bring your right hand behind your head. Push into your left hand, roll your chest open to the right. Revolve halfway. Yes. Maybe stack the arm up. Maybe find the back foot and open up. Beautiful. Come to chair pose, nice and easy. Forward fold, exhale. Halfway, inhale, stay here, stay here. Right leg reaches back in space. Left hand comes behind your head. Push down to open up. Maybe stack that left hand up. Maybe bend the right leg, find your foot, and kick the foot back. Yes, revolves half moon. She's not easy. Receive the pose. Don't try so hard, just receive it. Yep, yep. Beautiful. Chair, top of the mat. Nice and low, nice and low, nice and low. And then take it all the way back. Bridge pose, right into it. Bending the knees if they're not already. Pressing the shoulders down, rising up here. Press into the big toe, the base of the big toe, the inner foot. Last inhale, release down with your exhale. Receive the pose, bring your feet a little closer to each other. Press your feet down, bridge up again. Bring your hands to your hips, stabilize the hips, pick up the right leg. Extend the right leg up. Notice how the right side might want to shorten. Don't let that happen. Don't let it happen. Push into the left big toe. Good. Transition is everything. Bring the foot back down. Pause. You're still in bridge. Pick up the left leg. Extend up. Push into the right big toe. Press down into the right heel to lift up.
I still really, really love you. Yes, I do.
Transition is everything. Foot down. And then with control down. Pause. Receive. We've got one more. If you want to do Urdhva Dhanurasana with single leg up, you
have that option. If you want to just repeat bridge pose with or without single leg, it's your call.
For order down your asana, hands come by the ears. Inhale, rise up. So you don't get the feedback of your hands at your hips. Can you take your time here and find the length in the right side butt? Bring the leg back down, transition with care. And then left knee up. Extend the leg. And then bend the knee. Release the foot. And then all the way down. Really, really nice. Circle the wrists. Take the feet wide, drop the knees into each other. Reverse it. And then hug the knees into your chest or take happy baby, whatever's better for you. So we're going to take about a minute, 2 minutes, maybe about a minute and a half. How's that? Handstand, headstand, shoulder stand, or just stay here on your back and then take your legs up. So this is perfect. If you want another shot at headstand or handstand, you'll come up. Receive the pose. Stop trying. Let all the work that you've done guide you in. Who cares if it's not perfect? Who cares if it's not what you think it needs to look like? That's part of the process. So every day is different, and we allow ourselves to stay open and receive whatever's happening on any given day, we stop trying to squish ourselves into this pattern that we think we belong in. So some days it comes easy, some days not so much. Just receive it, just receive it. Don't judge it, don't be mad about it. If you are in a headstand, child's pose, please. If you are in a handstand and you want to stretch out your wrist, you can come into Paddha Hastasana, or you're good, we're going to come down to seated when you are ready with your legs out in front of you. You'll bring your hands next to your hips with your fingers pointing forward. Press down to open the chest, to lift up. To feel a rise in the spine, a rise in the crown of the head. We often lose this when we come into the forward fold. I don't care how far forward you come. Keep the length. Keep this belly lifting. Rise up. You know how it feels when we're holding the leg out in front of us when we're standing? It's that in the belly here. And then come forward. Find whatever you can hold on to. Pull your heart forward with an inhale. And then exhale, release down. Then inhale, pull your heart up. Exhale, release. Bring the soles of the feet together. Lift the heart and hand. And then exhale, come forward again. So instead of feeling like you're trying to smash your knees down to the ground, let go of that. Think about pushing the feet into each other to extend legs outward, the knees outward. Rise up with your inhale. Draw your knees into each other.
come onto your back. We're going to finish with a twist. Whatever twist you like. It could be one leg crossed over the other. Take the knees to whichever side your body is craving. Come back to center and then switch. Other side. And then back to center for Shavasana. Don't try to be here, just be here. Receive, receive, receive the end of your practice. Receive all the work you've done. Allow your breath to deepen. And then bring a hand to your heart and a hand to your belly. Feel the breath as it comes in your body, as it exits out. And then bend your knees. You can roll to your side, you can rock to seated, whatever is better to you. And then once you are seated, lift your spine, just feel your practice in your body, feel your practice in your mind, in your general state of being. Draw your hands together at your heart in gratitude for this body you're given, for this practice you've chosen to have in your life. And from the benefits you receive, you receive. Together, inhale. Together, exhale. Bow your mind to your heart. Rise with your inhale, eyes opening gently. Thank you. Thank you. Namaste.